And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Blind, Part 90. I am the RPG chick. We're heading back to the Normandy because we apparently don't have a main quest right now. We just have a bunch of little side things. Oh, Ashley.
Shepard, I don't know what to say. I'm trying to go over everything in my head, make sense of it.
Well, next time, just believe me. Why were you helping Odina? Well, that's a stupid question. She didn't know what Odina was up to. But I'll ask it.
Your bandages were still fresh. How did you end up working with Odina?
You saw me in the hospital. I was going crazy. Felt like I was letting everyone down. When Odina offered to make me a Spectre, I thought it was a chance to do some good.
I couldn't just sit back and watch either.
Yeah. But it sure turned into a mess.
Well, we are lucky. We stopped him before Cerberus took over the Citadel. And we saved the council, the entire council.
That could have ended very badly.
Very badly. Glad we're both still standing.
That makes two of us.
Stopped Odina and got to walk away. That's the important part.
I can't believe he was responsible for all of
it. Sorry, guys.
Was he indoctrinated?
It's hard to say.
Could be.
How do we fight something that can worm its way into your head?
I don't know. But we don't have a choice.
I wanted to talk to you about that. Hackett asked me to join his team. It's a great offer, but I'd prefer to ride this thing out aboard the Normandy.
Okay. If that's what you prefer, then welcome aboard.
Permission granted, Lieutenant. Just keep your gun pointed at the Reapers, okay?
I'd prefer it, thanks.
Grab your gear and find a bunk, Williams.
Aye, aye, Captain.
And Ash.
Yeah?
It's good to have you back.
Yes, ma'am.
Yay. Well, I never liked Ashley much, but it is good to have her back. As long as she behaves herself from here on in.
Shepard, I got Anderson patched in.
Nice.
Just getting him up to speed.
Both of them.
Odina. That SOB was always power hungry.
But this... Cerberus was just using him to take control of the Citadel.
What the hell for?
I don't know. Not yet.
Could have been a lot worse. Shepard stopped the assassination attempt on Counselor Ashiel. Kai Lang.
You know Kai Lang?
I'll have Hackett send you my reports on him.
You know Kai Lang, exactly what I said.
I take it you two have met.
Kaylee Sanders and I had our share of run-ins with him. I shot him in both legs once.
Wow.
Thought that might be the end of him. But he showed up again on Omega, even stronger.
Elusive man patch him up?
His legs seem fine.
That'd be my guess. Given what they were able to do with you and Grayson, it's a safe bet Lang's even more dangerous now.
Well, he will die like all the rest, but thanks for the intel.
I'll take whatever advantage I can get against these bastards.
Their attempts may have had at least one unintended side effect. I received word from the Asari counselor. They're requesting an update on the Crucible.
Lang has them scared. Enough to send help?
Yes, the Asari and Solarians are both throwing in their support now.
How's your progress on the Crucible?
Good. Our estimates suggest we've completed nearly 50% of the known work.
So quickly?
Once decoded, the schematics are designed in such a way that allows our scientists to easily translate the information. It's not Prothean-specific.
Okay.
Are we any closer to understanding how to use it?
That's still open for debate. Utilized in the right fashion, our scientists are convinced it can generate enough energy to destroy the Reapers. The question is, how will it dispense the energy? And in what form?
You mean, how do you stop it from wiping us all out?
Exactly. We think the catalyst is the key to determining how to focus its energy, how to direct its energy at the Reapers alone.
I'm working on that.
You'll find the answer, Shepard. I'll send you an update on the schematics. And in the meantime, we'll keep building.
And we'll keep fighting. Make sure there's an Earth left to come back to.
Right. It's good to see Anderson again. I won't fail you.
You've always trusted me. I won't let you down.
We're still in this. The gods of war haven't given up on us yet.
Good luck, both of you. Anderson out.
Commander, the Tyrian fleet is stretched thin. We need more support ships. And the Quarians are willing to talk.
Understood, sir. I'll look into it.
Be careful. We've got reports of instability along the Geth border. Hack it out.
Shepard, do you have a moment? A contact within Asari High Command was insistent I pass on a distress signal to you.
Oh?
Something they can't handle?
From what I can tell, they sent several commando squads to investigate. None of them returned. They didn't ask me directly, but I think High Command is hoping you might help.
What's your take on this?
That they wouldn't ask for help if it wasn't important. The colony's coordinates are on the galaxy map. I'll try to figure out what's going on.
Okay. Priority Perseus Vale. Sign a distress signal. Okay. So now we have main quest and another quest to do. Codex for the Cerberus coup. And Lessus? I'm gonna look at those codex, but first let me check out our new assets and such, our updates. Volus Dreadnought Kunu. The Volus have only produced one dreadnought, the Kunu, named after the diplomat who negotiated their client race status with the Turians. The Kunu is the only Volus ship of its class, but it is remarkably well armed. Look how far we are still, but only 50% of that. Its broadside cannons and main gun are all Thanic's magnetic hydrodynamic weapons. A Turian general touring the Kunu after its maiden system voyage enthusiastically declared that the ship could char a planet three times over. While its construction was funded entirely by the Elkos Combine Corporation, the Dreadnought was jointly gifted to the Vol Protectorate and Turian hierarchy upon completion. Turian fleet. Right, this is new. This whole thing is new. First it was updated, and then it was, you know, added. or created. The once formidable Batarian Navy was all but annihilated when the Reaper struck Karshan. The enraged survivors have gathered into a single remaining fleet. Batarian refugees are enlisting by the thousands, desperate for a sense of purpose after the destruction of their home world. No collection of vessels is more eager to engage the Reapers than Karshan's last warships. Updated. As the highest-ranking officer left in the hegemony, Balak is now the last Batarian military leader. His leadership, drive, and barely-contained fury have galvanized his troops. While Balak bears a deep hatred for the Alliance, he would do anything to save his people, and has grudgingly joined forces with humanity to stop the Reapers. Updated again. The Batarian refugees are rallying around the Pillars of Strength, finding courage in this sacred ancient artifact's recovery. Okay, so it said it was updated and then created or something, but I think it was already here with this update. I found the Pillars of Strength a while ago. Citadel Defense Force. It's going to read updated. An increase in refugees on a Citadel depleted resources that might have otherwise gone to defense systems and personnel. Warning people on the Citadel to prepare for the war has improved civilian readiness. Commander Shepard restored duty pay to spouses and family of active service people, improving morale on the Citadel. Spectre authorization released medical supplies from customs to Huerta Memorial Hospital, improving the quality of patient care. A Spectre gave CSEC permission to tap into surveillance on private citizens. CSEC used the footage to make several arrests, improving security. CSEC was authorized to train a civilian militia, strengthening their defense forces. Housing was found for students from Grissom Academy too young to work on the Prothean device. These gifted teenagers have been helping, however, by dealing with any repetitive problems that can't be delegated to VIs. CSEC is focusing on smaller crimes and misdemeanors. This has spread their forces thin, decreasing efficiency when dealing with larger threats. After reassurances that keeping money in the bank is critical to the war effort, Volus merchants are making donations to relief efforts and defense forces on the Citadel. Schematics, recovered by Commander Shepard, are helping CSEC easily locate and shut down active turrets left by Cerberus on the Citadel. Schematics of advanced bionic amplifiers from Grissom Academy increase the endurance of the Asari under fire. And the Book of Plenix declares that every Volus must aid those in need during times of want. News of the book's recovery inspired many Volus citizens to donate generous amounts to Citadel charities and defense funds. Well, that's good. Now, this should be changed because I told them not to focus on smaller crimes and misdemeanors, but to focus on the big picture. That was an episode or two ago. Maybe three. Asari. Asari science team. Many respected Asari scientists have used their long lifespans to become leading experts in their fields. Asari scholars often gain perspective on how cultural shifts affect society, grasping the larger contextual forces behind new proposals and using this to springboard into hypotheses years ahead of their time. The Asari science team working on the Crucible consists of some of the keenest scientific mavericks in the galaxy, eager to contribute to its construction. Asari Second Fleet. Largely composed of frigates and fighters, embodying the Asari's hit-and-run mindset with a nimble swarm rather than a slower collection of vessels. The second is normally dispatched to protect colonies from pirate raiders or mercenary activity. The Second Fleet's fighter squadrons are intensely competitive, racing to break new records set by other teams, but unquestionably loyal to each other in a fight. And the Asari Sixth Fleet. It has more dreadnoughts than any other collection of ships in the Asari Navy. An almost superstitious dread has grown around its entrance into conflict. As any war with the fleet has never remained small, it was the Sixth Fleet that flew against Arachni in the beginning of the Arachni Wars, and it was the Sixth Fleet that liberated the first colony under siege in the Krogan Rebellions. Unfairly or not, its service people have a reputation for being sober, serious, and humorless. Nevertheless, the Sixth Fleet is a welcome sight for any ally when it arrives. Salarian. STG Task Force. While the Citadel Council officially dismissed the existence of the Reapers for years, high-level STG operatives harbored suspicions that their return might be imminent after the Battle of the Citadel. These leaders quietly began to advise the Special Task Group to prepare for the worst. In accordance, the STG is ready to deploy a sizable task force to deal with the Reaper threat. Anturian. Turian Sixth Fleet. The Turian Navy has the most dreadnoughts of any known species in the Milky Way. The Turian hierarchy limited production of these ships only because the Treaty of Phyrexian, I'm sure, directly controls the number of dreadnoughts due to their destructive capabilities. The Turian Sixth Fleet is technically classified as a peacekeeping fleet. Before the Reapers, it was chiefly used to patrol the space around the Citadel. Now it's ready to fly to areas trying to fight off the invasion. Okay, that's it. All right, these codex. Oh, we got mission summary too. Asari High Command has requested help dealing with the distress signal on an Asari colony. Go to the colony and investigate the situation. And priority Perseus Vale. The Quarian fleet offers both technical specialists and support ships to assist with the Crucible. Meet the Quarian admirals and contain their help in the war effort. Unfortunately, this is the part where Tali would become involved, but she died at the end of Mass Effect 2, unfortunately. Still sad about that. So this apparently is the main quest, and this is probably a larger style. A small quest. And we're probably going to... All these other things that we've gotten are things that we uncover. All or mostly, well, except for the two I looked at, by scanning, you know, not scanning, but looking through systems, clusters and such. So we're probably going to look through all the clusters, all the new ones. We'll probably do that, and then if nothing else arises, I might head back to the Citadel to, like, clear all this up, in case, because last time I went to the Citadel, whatever I hadn't turned in, even if I found it, I couldn't turn it in. It sucked. So, and then finally the main quest. So, planets and locations, we have
the John Grissom Academy, an unremarkable world located far from regularly traveled trade routes. Lessus is inhabited only by a small Asari colony. The main feature is a monastery that houses a large population of Asari with active or latent Ardat Yakshi genes, a disorder that causes the death of anyone who mates with the afflicted Asari. Although some of the colonists exiled themselves voluntarily, many were sent to Lessus by their families to protect society from their deadly potential. The monastery emphasizes individual sacrifice for the good of the community. Latent Ardat Yakshi, as well as active sufferers who show that they can control their condition, may be offered a chance to reintegrate into Asari society after spending sufficient time on Lessus. Active Ardat Yakshi, whose psychological profiles show capacity for neither empathy nor re-education, are confined to the monastery for life.
So it's something having to do with this. Because this is where we're going. Wait. Masana. I'm guessing Masana is the name of the colony, and it's on this Lessus.
The John Grissom, an unremarkable world located far from regularly traveled trade routes. The Reaper called Harbinger is believed to be the oldest. Banshees are the corrupted Asari often found leading a Reaper strike force.
See this?
The Reapers create them specifically from Asari with active or latent predispositions to becoming Ardat Yakshi, a rare neurological condition that enhances the Asari's biotic power while causing the immediate death of anyone she mates with. Lumbering as though in constant pain, the emaciated Banshees are surprisingly durable opponents.
Active or latent predispositions.
The Reaper called Harbinger is believed to be the oldest. The brute Banshees are the corrupted Asari.
Becoming Ardat
Yakshi. A Reaper strike. The John Grissom Academy, an unremarkable world located far from regularly traveled trade routes, Lessus is inhabited only by a small Asari colony. The main feature is a monastery that houses a large population of Asari with active or latent Ardat Yakshi genes, a disorder that causes the death of anyone who mates.
So apparently, the Reapers are taking the Asari there to make them into these Banshees. So it probably, the mission probably has something to do with that. That's what I'm guessing. Anyway, the Reaper War. The Cerberus Coup. Counselor Udina's attempted coup will no doubt be analyzed for generations to come, but a clearer picture is beginning to emerge. Udina had contacted Cerberus to coordinate what was intended to be a bloodless takeover of the Citadel. Cerberus? Bloodless? What? In which he would force the other counselors to grant him emergency powers so that he could command the Citadel fleet. He would then direct the fleet to liberate his homeworld, Earth. The plan fell apart early when Executor Palin and the Salarian counselor caught wind of it. In defense of the plan, the elusive man dispatched his top assassins, commanded by Kai Leng, to kill them. Udina had little choice but to support the assassins with an armed force sufficient to hold the Citadel. Captured confidants have indicated that Udina and Ling's alliance was relatively fragile. Udina may have planned a turn on Cerberus once the fleet was his to command, and Ling departed when he calculated that Udina would not succeed. Persistent rumors suggest that Udina might have been a high-functioning victim of Reaper indoctrination. His actions played right into the Reaper's plans. Even if the coup failed, it would damage Citadel governance. If it succeeded, his plan to retake Earth would likely have turned into a military blunder that Council forces could ill afford. However, there is no direct evidence of his indoctrination, nor obvious opportunity. It is more likely that Udina acted out of desperation, and in doing so, cost humanity its counselor. Yep, he's dead. Oh wait, do I have any points I can spend? No, I want to increase... I think I want to increase fitness next. Anyway, let's get the hell out of here. We have to move on. Right, we haven't been back on the ship ever since, so we need a crew update.
Commander, I've got a lead on something interesting. Have you got a minute?
Sure.
Commander, I've found something you need to see.
What have you got?
A group of Cerberus scientists cut ties and fled. Perhaps they finally realized they were on the wrong side. We don't know what they were researching, but they were among the Elusive Man's top scientists. They could help build the Crucible.
If we can trust them.
Unless they're indoctrinated and this is a ruse to get Cerberus close to the Crucible.
I'm not suggesting we trust them fully, but it could be worth investigating.
True.
Has the Alliance tried to make contact with the scientists?
They've been unable to find them, but they're searching. As is Cerberus. I've been monitoring Cerberus communications. I've charted signal frequency from various Cerberus cells by location and cross-referenced known ship movements.
You found them?
I believe so. Yes.
Nice work. Put it on the map and I'll give it a look.
Thanks for your time, Commander.
Commander?
Ex-Cerberus scientists. I have something new in planets and locations?
Jellix. Second planet in the Arai system, is a marginally habitable world of mountains and ice. The planet was turned into a human penal colony upon its discovery in 2161. But its prison shut in 2179 after racking up the worst safety records in the system's alliance. Lawsuits are still in the courts. Shortly after the closure of the prisons, a handful of intergalactic corporations moved in to set up mines, supply depots, and other facilities on the planet.
Okay. I guess we're going there at some point. Array, ex-Cerberus scientists. A group of top-level scientists have cut ties with Cerberus and are fleeing their former employer. Rescue the scientists before Cerberus can find them. Oh, goody. There's my codex. I beat the notification. See if I have any email. Oh, wow, I have quite a few. Game night? From Samantha Trainer, Commander, thanks for taking the time to speak with the civilian. I'd love to see how Commander Shepard kills time between missions. Why don't you give me a call if you'd like to grab drinks in your cabin? I promise a night of fun and games. Trainer. Okay. Citadel Interview, Your Cabin? From Diana Allers. Networks are going wall-to-wall with coverage of the attack on the Citadel. Everyone's asking questions about Udina's death. Can I get an hour or so with you to talk about what happened? I'm thinking your cabin rather than the conference room so we don't get interrupted. I heard you knew the counselor personally. If you need some time alone or don't want to talk about it, just say the word, Diana. From from Jack. The students are kicking ass and taking names. They're keeping them on short rotation so they don't burn out. So we end up with lots of shore leave. Next time you hit the Citadel, come by Purgatory. I'll be there if I'm not blowing shit up in the field. Jack, we just met you in Purgatory. In Purgatory. ANN alert. New article on Cerberus. Elysium. An evacuation shuttle, nearly destroyed as it attempted to escape the Reaper-occupied colony of Elysium, was reportedly saved after a lone biotic worker intervened. The shuttle was carrying children who drew higher numbers on the colony's evacuation lottery, meaning they were not eligible to board the first wave of shuttles leaving the planet. Their shuttle was saved when the biotic, identified by authorities as Aresh Agdashlu, engaged Reaper forces that were preventing it from taking off. Agdashlu had a history of drug abuse and criminal activity and claimed to have survived a Cerberus camp on Pragya as a child. Witnesses said he killed several dozen Reaper creatures before he was overwhelmed, providing the shuttle with just enough time to fly clear. Durlesh Mole from Adrian Victus. Okay, that's the Primarch. Yeah, not his son, who is dead. Commander Shepard. Cerberus just ambushed a Terrian cruiser full of high-ranking hierarchy officials. The cruiser managed to escape, but its location was top secret. Cerberus couldn't have located that ship without inside information, and the only other person who knew the cruiser's position was Volus Ambassador Din Korlak. I've heard ugly rumors of a bounty out for his head. My advisors insist I can't bring these accusations against Korlak himself. Oh, Din. Din was the first Volus we ever saw in a room with two Elcor. And they were chastising rebuke, Din. My advisors insist I can't bring these accusations against Korlak himself. I admit they're right. The Turian and Volus economies are tightly intertwined, and now isn't the time for a political crisis that would result, but the security of our fleets is at stake. I ask that you investigate Korlak in your capacity as a Spectre and find out if he is, indeed, a Cerberus mole. I forwarded information on his last known location to the Spectre office on the Citadel. Why don't you forward it here? Regards, Primarch Victus. Forward it here. You make me run to the Citadel just to see where his location is. Got a minute. From James Vega. Hey, Commander, just wondered if you got some time in the near future. Nothing critical, just wanted to chat. Vega, okay. Kai Lang's dossier. From Stephen Hackett. Shepard, as promised, here's what we have on Kai Lang. Oh, he's so enigmatic. From Alliance Records, subject Kai Lang's dossier to Stephen Hackett. Name Lang Kai, date of Systems Alliance military enlistment. November 14, 2172. Age on enlistment 16. Credentials faked. Tours of duty 2172. Terminus systems, patrol and reconnaissance. 2173. Exodus cluster, patrol and reconnaissance. Reprimanded for taking medals from dead enemy officers. Sentence reduced in light of previous exemplary service record. 2174. Raid of Ention. Recommended for Systems Alliance Medal of Valor. 2175, Kite's Nest, Tactical Reconnaissance, accepted into Interplanetary Combatives Academy. 2176, received N7 designation from Interplanetary Combatives Academy. Wow, he's an N7. 2176, dishonorably discharged and imprisoned after charge of first-degree murder. Right after you got your N7 designation. Cerberus activities. Intel on Kai Lang's activities after joining Cerberus is spotty. What is known as the elusive man arranged for Lang's escape from prison, employing him as an operative for the next 10 years. Lang is now believed to be the elusive man's most trusted agent, working as an infiltrator and assassin. His cybernetic modifications appear to include Cerberus's Phantom class implants. Priority, Citadel shore leave. From Admiral Hackett, Commander Shepard. I'm ordering the Normandy into dry dock on the Citadel for much-needed repairs. She's seen a lot of action lately and needs a little TLC. I'm just leaving the Citadel. A small army of techs will take care of the details once you arrive, so let's get your crew out of there. You're all on shore leave. That's an order. We need everybody at their best. I'm not yet, buddy. We got stuff to do. One more thing. Admiral Anderson has an apartment on the wards. Head over there when you arrive. I hear it's a nice place. Admiral Hackett. Oh, we can go to Anderson's apartment. Cool. Not yet, though. Journal updated. Shore leave.